Hey, welcome back to Self Love and Sweat, the podcast. Today, we're going to talk about how to master your morning, how to stop feeling like you are all over the place in the morning, snoozing out of control, waking up without a plan, and then just feeling like the day is dragging you along. We all have days like this. I mean, even I have days like this where, yeah, I just feel like my morning is not the way that I would have it ideally. And when it's not, it just feels like the rest of the day is a little bit funky. And while I do have tips and tricks that I use as well to help just kind of reset and recharge throughout the day, kind of set your mindset as well to just kind of like gain some perspective and continue to keep on keeping on. What I can say for sure is that when you start in the morning, when you master your morning, when you make your mornings a priority, the rest of the day is just better. It just is. The rest of the day is better, which makes your weeks better, which makes your months better. The world's top high performers in the world, right? They all have a morning routine. They all do something in the morning to get their day ready. That's for them, right? It's not like doing all these things for other people first thing in the morning. It is, how can I set myself up in the morning? How can I master my morning so that I don't feel like I'm crazy busy all over the place, running on a hamster wheel, trying to get everything and everyone and all the things and all the stuff done? You really can show up and master your morning. And these tips really like are everyday tips. These are for anyone and everyone. So take notes, tune in, make sure you're paying attention and think about which one of these tips resonates with you the most. Which one is really a key area that's going to help you master your morning and help you up level that experience in the morning, right? Creating that experience for ourselves in the morning instead of just like waking up and just like go mode and all the things pulling us all different directions, right? We really can choose to create an experience in the morning. And that's what I really want for you guys. These are everyday tips. These are tips for anyone. Like I said, I really feel like while you can manipulate some of the things that happen in the morning, depending on the season of your life or you are, what you're doing, whatever. What I'm going to share with you today will work whenever. Like you really can pull these out of your toolbox anytime. And honestly, I feel like I want people to for sure be motivated to work out when they think about me and they think about the work, my coaching and stuff like that. Definitely want people to move their bodies, right? But I also like a close second, if not maybe even like a tie, I've never kind of thought about what, you know, is the most important in this list. In fact, this is just kind of coming to me here. But one of the most important things that I implement with my clients and what's something I always come back to as a foundation, a foundational tool is mornings, morning routines, how you're showing up in the morning. You know, I don't always say like, you know, wait till Monday or wait till tomorrow to start fresh. But if you continue to show up in the morning, like I said, to create that experience, you get that opportunity to have a fresh, fulfilled start every day. And I feel like that is awesome. And I want you to have that too. So here are some key tips on how to master your morning. Okay. So the first tip is that to master your morning, it is not with your phone, TV, email, computer, Netflix, social media. A solid morning routine, a routine that is going to help you master your morning and also the rest of your day, the rest of your week. It does not start with your phone. It does not start with, you know, flicking on the TV and the news and getting connected and trying to figure out all the things that you can, you know, use to stimulate your mind and kind of get you going and make you figure out kind of where you are and what you're at, where you're at and what you're going to do next, right? Those are like all familiar things. And I really find that the power of silence in the morning and not being connected and being able to do what works for you first before checking into things like email, social media, like that's everybody else's world. That's all the things. That's like, you know, everybody else's to-do list in our emails. Hey, Lunden, can you do this? Can you check this out for me? You know, can you send me this link? You know, can you do this? Can you sign up here? Like whatever. That is not for the mornings. So I'm also going to throw in a caveat here because I use my phone in the morning. And here's how. And this is not for any of the things that I mentioned, like for email, social media, you know, Netflix, blah, blah, blah. And my phone is on airplane mode. So if I don't remember to turn my phone on airplane mode before I go to bed, then I just turn it on in the morning when I wake up and grab my phone. First rule of thumb is, I'll say this afterwards because this is part of my morning routine. But I use my phone in airplane mode because I use an app in the morning that is super important to me. An app that I love, an app that's changed my life, and an app that helps my morning tremendously. I wake up in the morning first, and I'll talk about this in my morning routine, but I get water and I'm just kind of like a little bit into my body in the morning. And then I will open up my phone to my Bible app. And I use the Bible app, for those of you that maybe haven't heard of it before. It's the Bible app. It's the Bible on your phone pretty much. And there's a bunch of different plans that you can do for all sorts of things, also all sorts of seasons in your lives. And I do a morning devotional with some of my dad's sisters, so some of my aunts, and it's really awesome. And then I have some other plans that I do on leadership, on focusing on different people in the Bible, because I feel like those stories are so magnificent. And I just love to read and learn about amazing people doing great things and great works of faith. And so that's on my phone. So what I mean is, we're not getting on our phone to check our messages, to see who called us or FaceTimed us or sent us a like on Instagram, or, you know, had something to say to a message we sent to them yesterday via email, whatever. Using your phone to do something like that is different. You know, if you have like an app on your phone that's a gratitude app, or like I have the Bible app, there's some things where I feel like it's super beneficial to have that. And then I just have rules surrounding all the other things. So it's like not until about 8 o'clock in the morning. I wake up usually between like 5 and 6. So not until 8 o'clock in the morning can things like that start to come into my realm, if that makes sense. So I'll like start to open up, you know, Instagram and my messages and other apps around that time. But I use my phone in the morning to do my devotional in my Bible app. And so to master your morning, it's not with your phone. Like I said, it's not connected to all the other outside things. But one rule I have for myself that I make super important, because I'm like, okay, I'm using my app, but I'm opening the Bible app. And as I was, to be honest, as I was doing this, like creating these new habits, wiring this new kind of routine in me, I would open up social media a lot. Like you just kind of like realize like, oh yeah, I just opened up this app. I have my phone in my hand. I just like my thumbs just moved. Like I just went to my messages. I just went to Instagram. Like there's a lot of like autopilot surrounding our phones, especially with me surrounding my phone. And so I would just find that I'd pop into some of those apps and have to like just kill them really fast. Just like, you know, exactly like some of those thoughts that come in. It's just like, oh, we opened it. Whoops, get rid of it. And I think that that's really kind of like a fun little parallel there to think about that, because yeah, you don't just like say you're going to do something and then never do it again. It's just like, it pops up and you shut it down really quick. Right. So I decided that like, okay, feet on the ground in gratitude before even grabbing your phone, Lunden. So that was something that was really important to me, to not just like roll over, grab my phone, open up the Bible app, maybe something. Like I wanted to bring a bit more intention into my morning. So feet on the ground in gratitude. Then I'll usually go to the bathroom, grab something to drink, grab some water, maybe take my vitamins, and then come back in to grab my phone and like go into this moment of prayer and connection with God and being in this devotional and in this app. And it's cool because I can use it in airplane mode and I can read through everything that I want to. Don't open all the other apps. And I've gotten really good at that. It took me a while though. It's like, sometimes you just get sidetracked and you just forget and you're just like opening up things, like I said. So that took time. But if your phone is going to be involved in your morning routine, make it something that's dope. Make it something that is not, you know, comparing social media, email, you know, like I said, Twitter, all the things. Like make it something that is really going to be beneficial for you to master your morning. Yeah. You're not going to be scrolling through, doing the scroll before your feet hit the ground in gratitude. Okay. At the very least, feet hit the ground in gratitude. Are you with me? Okay. So the next one I want to talk about, like I said, in the first one, I kind of alluded to it a little bit, was my morning routine. I feel like morning routines, hydration, getting enough steps, these are like foundations and basics that we need to continue to review and revise. And with that being said, your morning routine can continue to be reviewed and revised. I wouldn't say every single day, but you know, are you at home? Are you traveling? Are you going to be through a different season of, you know, maybe you're in school or out of school, or the kids are not. So it's like things like that need to be dynamic. And so that's why I like my 3M formula for a morning routine. The 3Ms stand for mindset, movement, and me time. Mindset, movement, and me. So for me, the mindset is my devotional. That is me getting my mind right in the morning, doing that prayer. I do a lot of gratitude. I say thank you repeatedly in the morning. That's like a little mantra that I say to myself. I'm just like, thank you, thank you, thank you. Movement, that can be your workout. That can be any kind of movement, but get moving. So whatever type of movement that might be, great. If that's your workout, awesome. But just because you worked out in the morning doesn't mean that you don't get to, or that you're you're exempt from moving later on. So make sure that you continually move your body regularly throughout the day to stay mobile, to stay flexible. You know, we don't want to be stagnant. Okay. So movement in the morning of any kind. Sometimes that's listening to your favorite song and dancing. Maybe that's a dynamic warm up. Maybe that's going outside for a walk. Maybe that's stretching and then a little bit of a yoga flow. A lot of my clients like to do like 10 minutes in the morning on their mat, which is really cool. So it's like, even if you just kind of wake up and want to start moving on your mat, and then maybe that leads to a run or a walk or a bike ride or some strength training, or maybe that's just what you got for the day and you're just going to continue to move throughout the day, then that's awesome. I think that that morning movement is a great bookend. Even like after a long day, it feels so good to go for a walk or go for a jog or get outside and just move your body a little bit too. So that way there's kind of like that start movement and then the end of your day kind of movement shakeout, if that makes sense. I like to do my workout usually in the morning or like around 10, 10:30, 11-ish, but I had a long day of working. And at the end of the day on, I think it was Friday or Wednesday, I can't remember what day it was. Anyways, I was like, I'm going to go home and do a shakeout run and just like run and just shake out my hands and like shake out my body and just like let some stuff go. And that can be a really powerful bookend to the end of your day too. Really, really powerful. Even like a walk or just like getting outside and moving, especially if you're like working from home. And a lot of us, I mean, I know a lot of people are working from home or have worked from home or whatever. Where I am set up here now and recording my podcast, I'm in my bedroom. So I have like an office desk set up right in front of the windows to have some good natural light. I have it kind of pivoted in a way that it keeps it kind of separate from my bed. Like it's not facing it. And it's kind of like, yeah, creating like space within space. And so like in theory, I could go from like bed to sitting here and like never go outside, right? I don't even need to go out to the car to go somewhere to do that, right? So I think it's really important to make sure that we use that movement in the morning to get outside, to get moving if we can, especially get some fresh air. And then in the evenings too as well, it's super awesome because there's been days where I'm like, huh, did you go outside today, Lunden? And you know, I think that when we do that home office experience, I think we all kind of know, I'm raising my hand, what a day like that can be like or feel like. And then me time in the morning. This is completely customizable to you. Yay. So me time, what is that? Reading some pages in your favorite book, having just a moment of silence with your coffee or your tea, a glass of water. Maybe that's just like walking outside and taking some deep breaths and just closing your eyes and listing some things you're grateful for. Maybe that's like a foot massage for yourself. Maybe that's a shower, like just taking a shower and letting the cold or warm water, sometimes a mixture of both. I like to do that kind of like hot, cold, 30 seconds on, 30 seconds, or not off, but 30 seconds cool, 30 seconds warm water. And that really is good for circulation and like getting the blood pumping in the body and just kind of waking you up a little bit too. Like that could be a really good me time for you. Everyone's different. And I think that a lot of times the people that I work with, especially the women that I work with, I don't have enough me time. I have no time for myself. I'm doing everything for everyone. I don't have time for me. And so I think that when you do that in the morning and you set that trajectory and you show yourself how you want to treat yourself, right? Like I'm starting my day thinking about me and putting, you know, what I need to really shine bright, you know, in what I do and how I live and for the people I serve and for everything that starts with me too. And so I think that when you think about that, it's like, well, what does that me time look and feel like for you? And for a lot of the women I work with, it really is like that warm cup of coffee or tea and just sitting in a moment of silence and like drinking it and then like smelling the cup in between sips. Like that is a moment of pure bliss in some, you know, in some lifestyles, because it's like things are go, go, go. Things can be really loud. And that moment of solitude and silence and just like having that coffee in peace or having that tea in peace is really powerful. So whatever speaks to you or works with you, right? So those three M's, mindset, movement, and me time. And plug that in. Plug that into your life. I say at least 5 minutes for each of the M's. So like 15 minutes, if you can give yourself in the morning. I prefer the longer, the better, to be honest. Like I'll do, you know, 20, to 20 minutes to an hour of meditation and devotional and mindset stuff in the morning. And then movement wise, it might be like a 20 minute walk and then I'll get to my workout later. And then my me time is journaling and, you know, looking through some of my notes that I've done, you know, after meditation and just kind of going through and like highlighting different things. That me time also involves a cup of coffee, which I love. And then I just kind of like write down and take notes and look at previous notes and just kind of think about previous themes that people have come to me asking about. And then I'll make lists of like, yeah, like, you know, video topics I want to make and podcast topics I want to make and things I want to talk about and things that are important to me. And, you know, even if I'm looking, you know, at during that me time, I'm looking back at previous entries too. So I'm looking at progress, like, oh, I remember when that was super challenging for me or when I went through that or when that happened. And here I am, you know, taking some notes on how I'm feeling now and journaling on how I'm feeling now. And there's progress there. I see that. There's been growth. Wow. Okay. What can I share there? How has that been valuable in my life? And how can I share that? And I think whether you share that or not on social media, like I do, recognizing that is so powerful. Looking back at your progress is so powerful because especially in the morning to see how far you've come, you know, oh man, I crushed it in that situation. I'll have whole sessions with my clients, my VIP one-on-one life coaching clients, like reliving a moment where you just totally crushed it. Like, what did that feel like? What was that experience like? You know, what is that like? What did you kind of bring to the table there? What did you love about that experience? How could you create that again? You know, how could you show up even more? Like, you know, it's just like, it's so cool to go through some of those visualizations there. And so that me time for me is that there. It's really thinking about moments that I have crushed it, how I can show up in a way that makes me feel good, where I'm in congruent with my core values, where I can look at past experiences and say, oh, I made progress there. Oh, you know, that's really awesome. So whether you share it or not, I think it's really important to look back at that. And that's what I do because that's what really supercharges me in my coaching and in what I do here on podcasts and YouTube videos and just everything. Like I've been making content consistently surrounding, I started with more fitness and nutrition related content, but now it's really like life coaching, lifestyle transformation, movement, mindset, you know, communication, relationships, love with others, like all those things. But I've been creating content consistently since I was 17 and I'm 33 now. So that's a long time. And that just doesn't come out of, you know, my pure brain. It comes out of me, you know, doing the work with myself and for myself. And then listening to your guys' input too, and seeing the similarities and seeing where we can inspire one another and uplift each other and how I can coach to help you unlock that even further. And so during my me time, I do that as well. But like for whatever that looks like for you, right? And I'm just giving some like nitty gritty detailed examples because I feel like I want to inspire you guys to do that too. Like get super duper specific with your life and with your morning routine and what your me time looks like and what your movement looks like and what your mindset routine looks like. Like figure out and navigate what makes you feel the best in the morning and then continue to do more of that. Continue to do more of that. And it's just super, super powerful. So those are the first two tips I gave you, which is something about technology and not being connected and all of that. And then the morning routine, the three M's, and then a morning run through. This is super important because at some point you just have to do it. At some point you just have to like stop pressing snooze and get your ass out of bed and just do the morning routine. Like you just have to do it. And sometimes that can be the hardest step. In fact, oftentimes that is the hardest step for people to take is just to go through it. So sit wherever you are and close your eyes if you can. If not, just take a moment to eliminate all distractions. Don't be looking at anything, scrolling anywhere. If you can, just take a moment to think about your morning routine, waking up in the morning from like that moment that you open your eyes. And what does that look and feel like for you? Are you waking up, you know, scattered? Are you waking up really feeling at ease? You woke up, maybe you snoozed once, but not five times. So you were able to get up and get moving and maybe do some shoulder rolls and some neck rolls and like wiggle your ankles a little bit and just remind yourself that you're alive. And then you get some water and some hydration in you and you maybe do a gratitude list. Like, what does that look like? What do your three M's in the morning really look like? You know, then you get moving, maybe get your clothes on as you're listing your gratitudes and saying, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And just being grateful. Even in the mornings, you guys, where I feel like, oh my goodness, this is a, oh, the hardest, you know, still saying thank you throughout those mornings is so, so, so helpful. So helpful. So as you're going through this morning run through, really think about the best case morning scenario. What would that look and feel like for you? You know, what does that smell like? You know, what does that sound like? What does that taste like? What does that feel like? And at some point, like I said, you just have to do it. You have to write down and do what you say you're going to do. And then you have to do it again and again and again. And then you have to decide, does this work for me or is this not working for me? Am I banging my head up against a wall or am I showing up subpar and not doing what I know I need to be doing to start my morning off right? And I say that because sometimes as a life coach, those are the things that I have to say because it's sticky and it's messy and it's uncomfortable. But hey, you're not a little kid anymore. So no one's going to get mad at you if you don't do the thing, and no one's going to yell at you, and no one's going to whatever. Like, you're going to have to deal with you if you don't have to do the thing. Like, this is just real, you guys. And so starting your morning off in a way that makes you feel fulfilled, so that you can shine bright, so that you can be that beacon of light, so that you can continue to make that ripple effect in the world is really what it's all about. It's not about waking up in the morning and being happy that it's morning and turning yourself into a morning person and then needing to work out in the morning. You know, you don't have to be that that idea that the media has put out there, that like, that you don't have to be anything except for do what works for you to get to the results that you want to get to, right? So, you know, oftentimes it's like seen as this glory thing to like wake up and wake up early and wake up energized and like, yes, let's do it. And then do your super duper intense run and workout and do it first thing in the morning, gung ho. Like, that's not like the reality of most people's lives, and that's cool. But what's not cool is not caring. And what's not cool is not taking the time to start your engines, because it's so powerful to see what you can do in this world when you get your physical body, you get your mindset right, and you just set your day up in a way that is filled with gratitude and that you're just really like, yeah, ready to crush it, ready to crush it. And even on those days when you feel like, oh, maybe crush it mode is not fully on, I believe in my ability to kind of figure that out. And I know that even if things are feeling a little bit funk and I have to navigate through that a little bit, at least I know that I'm going to continue to show up. The people around me are going to continue to uplift me because I've cultivated that. And it's going to feel good to move throughout the day, even if my morning wasn't like, you know, absolutely perfect. So you can see like how, yeah, this is a podcast episode about a morning routine, but you can see how, you know, if you're not having a great morning and you go into a day surrounded by people who are not uplifting, who are not cheering you on, who are not in your corner, who are Debbie Downers, who are always complaining about all the same things, right? Like, that's important too, because sometimes it's, yeah, you can set your morning up right, but if you're not setting your tribe up right too, that can be really a big challenge as well. And you can see how all these topics, I can go in all different corners and open up different doors to talk about different things. And that's really what the podcast is all about, is continue to dig deeper on different, different corners there. But just for the sake of sticking to the morning routine here, let's just recap quickly how to master your morning in these three tips. Don't start with your phone, at least not in a connected way, in terms of email or Netflix, social media. Don't be on the computer looking up, you know, the latest news or opening up web browsers. If you're going to use your phone, have it be on airplane mode and have it be with purpose, like using a particular app or something in your phone that's going to help you supercharge your morning. Number two, your morning routine. Make it a priority and make it work and get your three M's on. And that is mindset, movement, and me time. Those three M's with a minimum of 5 minutes spent in each M, and more if you can. And then the last one is a morning run through. A morning run through, knowing that at some point you're just going to have to freaking do it, right? Imagine it, do it, go after it, do it again and again. Wake up even when you feel like, oh, I want to snooze, but I told myself, no, I'm going to get up and do it. I'm going to fight that. I'm going to, it's not like a necessarily a fight in terms of like, it's rewiring. It's literally rewiring. Your pathways that would normally just press the button and snooze or grab the phone and scroll and do all the things, like, they're being stopped dead in their tracks and detoured. And so that can be a very, like, if you're just used to driving to work and doing your things and going and whatever, and like you could get to work, right? Just go or wherever the grocery store and you're just driving and you could just get there probably without even thinking, your mind somewhere else, whatever. But what if there was a detour? What if there was like a, you know, it was like stopped, that stoplight you normally go through and then it's right there and you just turn right? What if it was like, no, you have to go right here and go all the way around and take this detour, whatever? You would notice that. It would be kind of annoying at first, right? And then if for some reason that detour became something that was more permanent and it wasn't a detour and they just changed the route, okay, then that's kind of like just the way that you go. And you kind of just adapt to that new route, right? So that's exactly what's happening in our bodies. And the cool thing is that that's possible. It's possible. It's not the most comfortable thing in the whole entire world. I'm not going to lie, but it's possible. It's possible to change your habits. It's possible to implement new strategies, new habits, new routines, and it's possible to master your morning. Like, it's actually possible. You have this capability in your body to change how your neurons and just how you show up and how that fires and wires and rewires and all those things. Like, you're really in control of that. And that's why I'm all about ownership. I'm like, point the fingers back at yourself, because there is possibility for shift and change. And if you are not someone who does anything for yourself in the morning, if anything, just waking up and putting your feet on the floor in gratitude and saying, I'm so thankful that I am alive, that's a win. Start there. Start there. Let me know how it goes, you guys. Master your morning. You will not regret it. And if you have any aha moments, never hesitate to share them with me. You can find, you can shoot me a DM. Find me anywhere as at Life Like London, but probably the best place to do that is Instagram, because I'm in my DMs there more. So you can send me a DM or you can hit reply to any of the emails that I send to you. And if you don't get emails from me yet, you can get something free on my website. You can pick up like my mindset and movement calendar. If you go to lifelikelunden.com, it's right there. You can just click, get that free calendar, give me your email, and then you'll get emails from me. A lot of cool stuff, a lot of great tips. And just discounts, fun stuff. You know, if my programs are opened, I'll let you know. And I'm just kind of letting you guys know what I'm working on. I share my workouts, healthy recipes, you know, mindset strategies that have helped me, what I do to continue to make progress over the years. So I'm really sending out a ton of value about once a week or every 10 days via email. And once you're on that list, you can hit reply to any of those emails and I will get back to you. You can hit reply even to the ones that say, hey, thank you. Here's your free e-guide. You know, you can just hit reply to that because that all goes directly to me. Yes, I do have some emails set up on automation because that makes it faster, right? If I'm asleep or doing something and you sign up for a calendar, free e-guide or my free mindset calendar, I want you to get it right away. So some of those emails will come out automatically, but if you just hit reply to any of those, they'll go directly to my inbox and I'll always get back to you as soon as I can. Okay. You guys are awesome. I appreciate you being here. I appreciate your 5-star reviews. I appreciate you showing up and rock your mornings, master your mornings. You're awesome.